Well, it's been pretty hot today. In fact, we had a huge jump just since yesterday where we topped out at least at 93 this afternoon. We had 18 days without 90 degree temperatures, and today we broke that streak and topped out at least at 93. It could go even a little bit higher than that. Now, we've had just a couple high thin clouds around the area today. Most of us have been dry. And why has it been so hot? We had this big warm front that moved through the state earlier today. Well, it was really overnight into early this morning, allowed all this strong southerly flow to come in, make it very hot, pretty humid out there too. And then we'll have to watch for our next approaching cold front, which could eventually bring us some relief. So that'll be something we will look forward to in the next couple of days. Still, it is going to turn fairly windy. It's going to stay pretty warm over the next couple of days. Weekend storms are likely, and then into next week, it will be closer to average high temperatures. So our wind tracker, as we go through the morning tomorrow, we're looking at 10 to 15 miles per hour out of the south and southwest. That's going to warm us up pretty quickly as we go through the day on Saturday. We'll see those increasing up to about 20, 25 miles per hour through Saturday afternoon. It'll stay breezy into tomorrow night, and then once again, as we head into the day on Sunday, we will be looking for pretty breezy conditions to last all the way through the middle part of Sunday. Of course, we're going to be looking for rain chances to hopefully cool us off, but also we do desperately need the rain as we go into the day tomorrow. Just some isolated showers. Sunday looks to be our best chance, mainly Sunday night into Monday morning. Those rain chances dip down a little bit on Monday, and then I think Tuesday, Wednesday should be generally dry as well. Here's what our future tracker shows. As we roll through lunchtime tomorrow, clouds start to roll into the state. There could be a couple isolated pop-up spotty showers into the afternoon. I still think a lot of us are going to stay dry as we go through the day Saturday. Looks like clouds will stick around Saturday night into Sunday morning as well. By Sunday at lunchtime, we should be generally sunny. It's going to heat up very quickly Sunday before clouds, showers, and storms arrive. Here's 6 p.m. on Sunday when we could be looking at rainfall spreading across the area. Looks like it could stay intermittent through the evening and then get pretty heavy overnight. We could be looking for some heavy rainfall, especially along and north of Highway 30. Big band of rain sticks around through, say, 5, 6 a.m. Monday morning, and then I think we'll start to see some drying into our Monday morning commute. So tonight, increasing clouds down to 72, and it looks okay, I think, for the farmers market tomorrow. We'll see 73 degrees. It'll be warm and humid at 7 a.m. It'll be breezy through the market and will be cloudy, but I think it will stay dry as temperatures climb all the way into the 80s by 1 p.m. We should top out at 89 here in the Des Moines Metro tomorrow afternoon. Clouds with isolated showers and storms through the day. And a look at the next 10. We top out quickly at 93 on Sunday before showers and storms arrive Sunday night. We dry out as we head towards the middle of the week, and it looks like a pretty typical week to ring in the first couple of days for the Iowa State Fair.